Hello, Priya ma'am. We'll be just starting. We are waiting for the participants to join.
Sure, sure. No issue. Just call me
yeah,
and
we have
just tell me whenever you want to start. I'm ready.
Sure. We are formally starting with the session. Gradually, people will keep joining. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Good morning. I extend a warm welcome to each and every one of you on the virtual portal of Mehichan Mahajan DAV College for Women. Respected Professor Priya Sipaha, our most valued guest for today, respected Madam Principal Dr. Nisha Bhargav, faculty members and dear participants. It's our pleasure to have you all today for the webinar on significant provisions for women in the Indian criminal justice system. Before we move on with the session, Let me mention the achievements of our institution. Meher Chand Mahajan GAV College for Women was established in 1968 to commemorate the exemplary contribution of Justice Meher Chand Mahajan to the cause of education. The foundation stone of the college was laid by the then Vice President of India, Dr. V.V. Giri. The institution celebrated its golden jubilee in 2018. Over the years, the college has emerged as an institution of eminence, offering a unique blend of tradition and modernity to its students. Known for its academic excellence, the college has been ranked amongst the topmost colleges of the country by leading national dailies and magazines such as India Today, The Week, and The Tribune. Our principal has been a pillar of strength and a real visionary behind the social outreach endeavors at MCM. Under her flagship, the college has scaled new heights in executing novel projects related to social issues centered around the youth. I take this opportunity to thank Madam Principal for supporting us in organizing this webinar on such a pertinent issue. I express my gratitude to Professor Priya for sparing her valuable time. We are delighted to have you with us, ma'am, and we are looking forward for your session. With these words, I would like to invite Dr. Bindu Chopra, senior faculty member from the Department of Sociology, to formally introduce our guest to the audience. Dr. Bindu. Yes, you are.
I think ma'am is not audible.
Audience, am I audible to all of you?
Now you are audible.
I'm sorry, there was some glitch, technical glitch, and I was not audible to all of you. Okay, so I extend a warm welcome to all of you at the virtual portals of MCM DAV College, a premier institution of higher education for women in the region. And thanks a lot, Dr. Bhavna, for introducing us with the theme of the event today. So today we are organizing an event on the criminal on the provisions of women in the criminal justice system, and we are also celebrating the Denim Day, which is Sexual Assault Awareness Month. Okay, so we are celebrating this, and to understand the intricacies of the criminal justice system, we have amongst us a luminary academician, and it's my privilege to introduce you all to our distinguished resource person, Professor Priya Sipeha. She is a professor of law and has relentlessly worked in the education management sector. She is an entrepreneur, also has a startup by the name of Law Colloquium, where she actively organizes seminars, workshops, webinars for legal understanding on diverse issues such as criminology, criminal law, personal law, torts, and contemporary issues. She is an active member of the International Society of Therapeutic Jurisprudence, USA, and member of the International Society of Criminology. She is a senior peer reviewer and member of the editorial boards in various national and international journals, notably in India, Japan, UAE, and United States. She is also a passionate writer. She has written 6 books and has also published numerous articles in national and international journals on various aspects of criminal law, criminology, phenology, and victimology. She has presented papers and acted as keynote speaker in several national and international conferences, distinctively in Harvard, Oxford, Cambridge, Bridgeton, to name a few. For her exemplary work, she has been conferred with various awards, such as the Best Presenter at the International Conference held in Singapore, Best Paper Award at the International Research Conference, Tokyo, Swami Vivekananda Excellence Award for Academic Administration by World Achievers Foundation and Confederation of Indian Universities, Delhi, Environment Protection and Development Award in 2017 by Scientific and Environment Research Institution at World Clean Environment Congress, then National Teaching Excellence Award from International Benevolent Research Foundation, Indian Education Award in 2019 for Research in Education, and Excellent Researcher Award in Female category by International Academic and Research Excellence. And it's a matter of pride that she has also been bestowed with Women Icon of the Year Award in 2020. Madam, we are extremely honored and elated to have a personality of your stature with us. And I welcome you with a virtual bouquet full of respect and admiration for the kind of work you are doing in this field. And it's our privilege to have you amongst us. So now I invite our resource person to share her experiences and expertise on this issue. Madam.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Bhavna ma'am and Bindu ma'am, for such a beautiful introduction and inviting me for this. I think this is one of the noble cause that the more and more we are going to educate and make people aware, that will help not only for us, but for the society. So I'm going to present. So I'm going to share my PPT with all of you. Just tell me whether it is... Yes. Am I audible and can you see the PPT?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. Now, basically, the topic for today is significant provisions for women in the Indian criminal justice system. Now, why I have selected this topic when Bhavna ma'am approaches me? Because today, as you are celebrating Denim Day, and this is something related with the sexual assault. So that's why if we are a woman and we really want to know what are our rights, what are the provisions in our criminal justice systems related to all the sexual assault also, and apart from it, what are the other things which we have in the criminal justice system. Now, as you know that it is, although it is said that we are not having anything, we are not having a right, we are not having equality, but I don't think that this is a right way to express our opinion regarding our criminal justice system or even the legal justice system, because I think there are n number of provisions are present in our legal system also and criminal justice system also pertaining to women. But the thing is, we are not aware of it. And some people who are aware, they are using and as well misusing this thing. So it's better to know what exactly are the provisions and how to use that provision and not to misuse that provision. That is really important to know. Secondly, although, as I said, there are n number of provisions in our legal system, but I have confined it to the criminal justice system. That means I'm focusing only on criminal law, that too on Indian Penal Code. Why? Because as you all know that in 2012 there was a very brutal case of Nirbhaya Kand. Nirbhaya case, I think everybody knows about Nirbhaya case, and that was a case which really shook the mind of every individual, not only in India but even internationally. That shook mind because it is considered as one of the most brutal gang rape in the history of India. So that was a case, and after that it was really demanded that there must be some amendment in the criminal justice system for in some of the provisions pertaining to women. So basically I'm going to focus on all the amendments which has been made after 2012, that means in 2013. What are the amendments specially for women in the Indian criminal system, and some other provisions also which I think is important for everybody to know. So let's start. So I'm going to start this. The first one is, which the first provision which I am going to tell you is something which otherwise every male think that this is his जिसको हम कहते हैं ना कि इट्स बेसिकली जन्म सिद्ध अधिकार होता है, इट्स अ बर्थ राइट जस्ट टू स्टॉक एनीवन. सो दिस इज, लेट मी टेल यू दैट दिस इज नॉट ओनली ऑफेंस नाउ. बिकॉज व्हाई इट इज ऑफेंस, बिकॉज इट हैज बीन अमेंडेड इन 2013. Now in 2013 it has been amendment, and this particular thing which is called as stalking is now an offense. Earlier it was not an offense. Now for you it is necessary to know the meaning of stalking. Basically whenever we say that stalking is there, we are having a perception that stalking means only of online. But you have to understand, stalking is not only online, it is online as well offline. Now meaning of stalking, agar hum hindi mein bolte hain to the meaning of stalking is peecha karna. Ab peecha karna, ab hindi mein jab hum bolte hain that it is easy to understand that peecha karna means obviously it is offline, but whenever we speak in English stalking, we definitely relate it with to online. So you have to understand. Now after 2013 there is a provision that if any person is stalking, that means if any person is chasing anyone, no matter it is offline or online, without the permission or without the will of any girl whom he is chasing, that will be amount as an offense under the Indian Penal Code, that too under section 354D of IPC. And for that the punishment will be 3 years if it is first time, and 5 years if it is a subsequent offense, and if it is a second time. That is there. So it is a serious offense now. So it is necessary for everyone to know that this is an offense, and for which there is a punishment also. But there is an exception also. If that particular stalking, no matter it is online or offline, if it is committed or if it is done just for a reasonable conduct or for a genuine cause, then it won't amount as a offense. But that particular thing has to be justified clearly in the court or in the front of the police officer that that particular stalking is maybe because अगर किसी को, किसी लड़की को कोई प्रॉब्लम हो रही है और उसके पेरेंट्स ने बॉडीगार्ड दिया हुआ है, और एल्स इफ अ पुलिस ऑफिसर इज टॉकिंग समवन जस्ट टू नो अबाउट द क्राइम और जस्ट टू नो जस्ट फॉर द सिक्योरिटी ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर पर्सन, तो देन द स्टॉकिंग इज जस्टिफाइड. सो दीज थिंग्स आर द जस्टिफिकेशन ऑफ स्टॉकिंग. So that has to be very clear, and if that is so, it is not considered as an offense. Otherwise, stalking is considered as an offense. For that, there is a punishment also. Now the next offense is voyeurism. Voyeurism in Hindi is peecha chup kar dekhna. Basically, I have made a separate YouTube video on this voyeurism also. I have my YouTube channel also by the name of Dr. Priya Sepaha only. So you can see for detail of this, you can see my YouTube video also. But I'm going to tell you what exactly is the meaning of voyeurism. As I said, that voyeurism matlab chip kar dekhna. Now chip kar dekhna means this is something very serious nature. when any person...
Excuse me, Dr. Priya, yeah. I just want to interrupt. Your PowerPoint presentation is not moving, I think.
It is not moving?
It's on the first slide only.
Oh, now can you see?
Yeah, now it's visible now.
I think it's not, whenever I'm sharing the complete, I think it's not visible. So I'll share
It's fine now.
Okay, so talking, I think everybody knows and understand what is talking.
Actually, ma'am, you have to do it manually, I think. Every time you have to click it for the next slide, I think. Only then it will work.
Yes, now voyeurism, can you see voyeurism?
Yeah, it's visible now.
It's visible. Now, the problem is when I'm sharing the whole window, the whole slide, then I think it's not moving. I don't know what happened. I think now, can you see?
Yeah, it's visible, ma'am. It's visible. The only thing, it was not coming to the next slide. Otherwise, it's visible.
No, but now when I'm sharing the content, whether it is visible now, the contents are coming.
Yes, the content is coming.
Okay. So you can read section 354C of IPC?
Yes, it's very much visible.
Okay. So every time I have to share. Okay, fine. Yeah. So voyeurism is, as I said, that voyeurism means to watch anyone, any lady, when she is in her private activity. Now that private activity means whenever she is in a bathroom, whenever she is in a changing room, whenever she is in her bedroom. All these activities are those things where anybody else is not supposed to see her. If anybody else is not supposed to see her, that means it is purely considered as her private activity. So if anybody is watching her, and if anybody is not only watching her, taking her picture, taking her video at that particular time, then it will be considered as an offense under section 354 of IPC. It will be considered as an offense. So this is something very serious. Now, for that, I always say in my every webinar, in every seminar, and to everyone, because I have taken this type of webinar with the schools girls also, and ye ek aisi cheez hai, for that you have to be aware, more aware. Whenever you are going to a changing room or trial room of any store, no matter it is a mall, no matter it is a branded store, no matter even in the bathroom of a mall, hotel, restaurant, airport, anywhere, you have to look around. Please look around whether there is any hidden camera or not. You have to be aware, cautious all the time. Look around, see, try to see that if there is any hidden camera or not, because this is a very, very serious and a very common crime, which is happening now these days. So if there is any camera, then you have to look around that. There is a very famous case of Smriti Irani related to this. Smriti Irani once in Goa went to a Fab India store. Fab India, you all know this is a branded store. When she was in a trial room, she saw that the camera was directly focusing on the trial room. वो ट्रायल रूम में एकदम फोकस कर रहा था दैट पर्टिकुलर कैमरा एंड शी वॉज अवेयर एंड शी वॉज विजिलेंट इनफ यू हैव टू बी विजिलेंट इनफ शी वॉज विजिलेंट एंड शी सॉ दैट देयर वॉज अ कैमरा विच इज डायरेक्टली फोकसिंग टू द स्टोर टू द ट्रायल रूम एंड शी रेज्ड हर वॉइस शी इज स्मृति ईरानी सो शी रेज्ड हर वॉइस एंड दिस इज अ वेरी फेमस केस And although उन्होंने बहुत माफी मांगी, उन्होंने कहा कि no, this is not deliberately, it is just a, but it cannot be said. This is not an excuse that it was not deliberated. But still, there was a problem. So you have to be vigilant. If it can happen to a Smriti Irani, who are we? And we have to be vigilant. So इसलिए it is necessary that there must be vigilance. So this is also a crime which has been mentioned under section 354C of IPC. Now you can see the other sentences also. Can you see?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So for this, the punishment, if it is a first conviction, it is first time, then the punishment is 1 year, but which may extend to 3 years and fine, depending upon the gravity of the offense. Then If it is second or subsequent conviction, then the punishment is 3 years and which may extend to 7 years and fine. So this is also a very serious offense, and for that, not only the other person, they have to be cautious, but you also have to be vigilant equally. Now the second thing, now you can see?
Yes, it's visible.
Okay. Now the third thing is word, gesture or act intending to insult the modesty of a woman. Anything related to these, this is also a serious offense. And you have to know this, that this has been mentioned under section 509 of IPC. That means whoever tried to, intending to insult the modesty of any woman, in which way a modesty can be insulted. First, if he is utters any word which is not at all appropriate for any woman to say in any way, that is also an offense. Usually, ladies take it for granted, and they usually, even the parents, teach their child that please ignore that person. Okay, you must ignore. Aapko har waqt jhansi ki rani banne ki zarurat nahi hai. That is okay. But it doesn't mean that you have to ignore not only once. Once it can be ignored. But if it is continuous, please do not ignore it. Because then, kya hota hai ki saamne wale ki himmat badhti jaati hai. Then it is a serious offense. So please do not ignore. Once you can ignore, but do not ignore for more than once. That too, this type of offense. I'm not talking about any serious offense like voyeurism or acid attack or anything else. I'm talking about only the utter of word. Kisi ne se bola hai aapko, then you can ignore only once, but not more than once. But that too depends upon the type of the word he is using. Again, that is also the seriousness of the word, seriousness of the sentence, and the combination of his gesture and posture also. Everything has to be taken under care. Then the second thing is any sound or gesture. Sound includes CT and everything. That sound, any gesture, any posture, or exhibit of any object, or intending such word or sound which shall be heard, or that such sound, gesture or object shall be seen by such woman, which intrudes upon the privacy of such woman. Agar is tarah se kuch bhi hota hai, to then it is considered as an offense for which the punishment is a simple punishment for a term which may extend to 1 year or fine or with both. So always remember that if any person is showing, even any person is sending you very bad or insulting your modesty type of SMS or even a WhatsApp messages, even email, that amounts to an offense. So you have to take it very seriously. Then the next thing is, which is very important, I think that this day is celebrating for this only, that is sexual harassment at workplace. So sexual harassment at workplace is a very, very serious offense. This basically has started after Bhavri Devi case. This particular thing also, I have made again a separate YouTube video of sexual harassment at workplace also in a very detailed manner about everything about the Bhavri case and about this thing. But definitely I'm going to tell you that this particular thing, sexual harassment at workplace, is considered as a violation of Article 14 and 21 of the Indian Constitution. Why? Because Article 14 is about the gender equality, because at one place you are saying that women are equal, and at the other place you are doing a sexual harassment at workplace of women. Secondly, it is again a violation of Article 21, which says about the right to life and live with dignity, and any woman can work wherever she wants to work. If you are at one place you are saying this, and at the other place you are violating that particular thing, that is something related to, that was a base of the sexual harassment of workplace after Bhavri Devi case. Now, after Bhavri Devi case, basically the sexual harassment at workplace, what exactly is the meaning of that? Because I think there is a confusion regarding this. So you must know what exactly is the meaning, when and how that particular, any gesture, any words, any posture or anything else can be considered as a sexual harassment. So you must know. First thing, any unwelcome sexual determined behavior, whether directly or by implication. That too, it can be by your colleague also, by your senior also, by your junior also, or any office attendants also, even the driver, even the pupil, anybody of your workplace, even your student. If anyone is making and is doing any unwelcome sexual determination behavior, that will amount as a sexual harassment at workplace. Secondly, it includes physical contacts also in advances and advances also. Any demand or request of sexual favors by the seniors or anyone else, even your students, I'm mentioning it again. That means any junior, any senior, anyone else. Thirdly, any sexual colored remarks that could be directly also in the way of SMS also, in the way of WhatsApp also, in the way of email also, or any other social media. Then showing pornography and other unwelcome physical, verbal, and non-verbal conduct of a sexual nature. All these things comes under sexual harassment at workplace. So this you have to be. Now, these are the things, but these things must be made at the time of your work and at the workplace only. I'm not talking about if anybody is doing this thing at your home or in the marketplace. That won't considered under this thing. That should be done at workplace only. So this is, that has to be clear. Secondly, now, after Bhavri Devi case, this particular thing has been raised, and although that case was bahut pehle way back, but finally, after all the fight and after all the things, Sexual Harassment at Workplace Prevention, Prohibition and Redressal Act was formed in 2013. Now, this is very... वेरी बहुत बड़ा है ये और बहुत सारी चीजें इस पर्टिकुलर एक्ट में बट द थिंग विच इज नेसेसरी फॉर यू टू नो इज दैट बेसिकली दिस डिफाइंस व्हाट इज सेक्सुअल हैरेसमेंट एट वर्क प्लेस विच आई हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड एंड ऑल्सो नॉट ओनली डिफाइंस नॉट ओनली से दैट दिस इज एन ऑफेंस बट इट ऑल्सो क्रिएट्स अ मैकेनिज्म फॉर रिड्रेसल ऑफ कंप्लेंट हाउ दिस द कंप्लेंट कैन बी मेड एंड वॉट इज अ मोड ऑफ रिड्रेसल ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर कंप्लेंट हाउ वी कैन प्रिवेंट एंड प्रोहिबिट दैट पर्टिकुलर एक्ट देन द नेक्स्ट थिंग इज इफ इट इज ऑल्सो प्रोवाइड्स द सेफ गार्ड अगेंस्ट द फॉल्स और मिलीशियस चार्जेस अ फीमेल विद द राइट टू फाइल अ कंप्लेन अगेंस्ट एनी सेक्सुअल हैरेसमेंट एट वर्क प्लेस नाउ देयर इज वन मोर थिंग विच आई वॉन्ट टू टेल यू थ्रू दिस वेबिनार इज This particular act is really very helpful and very good, not only for any government organization or a private organization or any institute. This is for everyone. No matter it is a domestic help or a maid of at your home only. अगर वो आपके घर की maid है तो उसके लिए भी ये act है. If it is related to a hospital also, it is related to a restaurant also, anywhere, whoever, any lady, whoever is coming for job, wo workplace par aa rahi hai. Aapka ghar, if a maid is coming to your place, that is also a workplace of that particular maid. तो वो आपको ध्यान रखना है कि बाई भी जो आ रही है जो आपके यहाँ काम वाली आ रही है वो भी काम पर आ रही है तो जब वो काम पर आ रही है मतलब आपका घर उसके लिए वर्क प्लेस है दैट यू हैव टू रिमेम्बर सो इट इज दिस इज वेरी वाइड इन नेचर सो एवरीबडी हैज टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस दैट एनीबडी कैन रेज अ वॉइस अगेंस्ट हरसेल्फ एनी फीमेल कैन रेज अ वॉइस अगेंस्ट हरसेल्फ अंडर दिस एक्ट बिकॉज दिस इज समथिंग फॉर वर्क प्लेस ठीक है तो दैट हैज टू बी अंडरस्टैंड फॉर विच इट इज नेसेसरी फॉर इफ देर इज एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एन इंस्टीट्यूट और एनी I said that no matter if it is a private or a commercial or a government organization, it is necessary for every organization. I think in your college also, there must be a internal complaint committee. Internal complaint committee is basically on the basis of the Vishakha guidelines. Vishakha guidelines jo hai, wo batai gayi thi, and everything has to be followed accordingly. the Vishakha guidelines. So there must be a formation of internal complaint committee in every institute, in every office, for which there must be 10 or more employees. They must be member of that particular committee. And if required, the district officer can also constitute a local complaint committee at each district. That is also necessary at block level. Then a complaint committee, if they require, they are having a power of the civil code, if required, because it depends upon the complaint, which type of a complaint a person is having. Then, as I said, that remedial measures under Vishakha committee has been mentioned, and that has to be followed. As I said, that it is a prevention and a complaint committee, prohibition and redressal act. So that's why if any lady is complaining against anyone to the internal complaint committee, now what are the measures can be taken by the internal complaint committee? First thing, there are two things. She can call, the complaint committee can call the person who is responsible for certain act for which the complaint has been made. So usko wo call karegi jisne wo kaam kiya hai, galat baat kari hai. The internal committee will call them. If it can be redress only by warning or only by a written sorry or apology letter, to, or usme if the complainant is okay with that, then it can be done within the internal committee. And if required, that to depend upon the gravity of the offense which the other person has committed. Agar wo sound ki baat hai, gesture ki baat hai, SMS ki baat hai, so that can be solved or resolved at that particular thing. But if it is crossing that particular thing, then this is something that's why the seriousness or the gravity of the offense is always required to consider at that particular time. So an apology letter can be written, a warning can be done, withholding the promotion can be done, there can be a counseling session also, and there can be a community services also. It can be a termination or termination letter for the respondent also, or if necessary, there can be punishment also. But if there is a punishment, then it is necessary to go to the district officer and file the complaint. These are the things. Then the process is, once the complaint has been lodged to the internal committee, it is necessary for the internal committee that the inquiry must be done within the 90 days, within the period of 90 days. And if necessary, if that particular matter cannot be solved by the internal committee, then they have to take the report and pass it on to the district officer, where again there will be inquiry which has to be settled down within 60 days. And if required, if that particular complaint is proved as a genuine one, then there will be action according to the complaint. Now there is one more thing. Whoever is a member of that particular internal committee, it is necessary for every member of that committee to do not share the information of that particular offense with anybody else. Wo jo cheez hai, that is really considered as very, very confidential. Why? Because that particular lady jo hai, jiske saath ye cheez hua hai, she is already terrorized. किसी के साथ भी इस तरह की एनी सेक्सुअल असॉल्ट और एनी सेक्सुअल हरासमेंट इफ टेक्स प्लेस, तो वो बहुत डरी हुई रहती है. तो वो अगर वैसे ही डरी हुई है, एंड इट टेक्स अ करेज टू कम टू द इंटरनल कमिटी एंड स्पीक अबाउट ऑल द थिंग्स व्हिच हैज हैपेंड टू हर, तो इट इज ऑलरेडी अ टाइप ऑफ अ जेस्चर ऑफ करेज व्हिच शी इज ट्राइंग टू से. एट दैट टाइम इट इज नेसेसरी फॉर द इंटरनल कमिटी टू काम हर डाउन, उसको शांत करें, उसको समझें. And it is your responsibility. Do not leak her. Make it confidential. Do not say it to anyone else. If this particular thing is safe, if any person is not keeping it confidential, then there is a penalty of ₹5,000 on that particular person. So ye cheeze aapko dhyan mein rakhni hai. So it is a requirement for every institution that there must be a internal complaint committee, and they must follow the Vishakha guidelines, and which comes under the sexual harassment cases. Now, the next thing which has been made is the amendment which has been made under the Indian Penal Code after 2013 is acid attack. And this is really the irony of India that there are n number of incidents of acid attacks, yet we were not having any law or any provisions pertaining to this in our criminal justice system. But nevertheless, ab ye ho gaya hai, so it's good that after 2013, acid attack is considered as an offense under section 326A of the Indian Penal Code, which defines acid. First thing, what is acid? That means anything which is having a acidic or corrosive character or burning nature that is capable of causing bodily injury, leading to scars or disfigurement or temporary or permanent disability. That is considered an acid. But the thing, the second point which I have shared, that is very important to understand, because this is the thing which is telling about the after effect of the acid attack. That means if that particular acid has a long-term consequences, not only physically, that it may include blindness also, permanent scarring of face and body also. This is something physical. Not only physical, but along with far-reaching social, psychological, and economic difficulty, that will amount as an acid attack. Now, the good thing which has been involved is there are two types of punishment. The first one, which has been mentioned under section 326B of the Indian Penal Code, is related to the attempt of acid attack. Even if the person is not she is not having any scars or anything, not attacked exactly by the acid, matlab usko koi harm nahi hua hai, us particular ladki ko koi harm nahi hua hai, but still the attempt of acid attack has been made, then also there is a punishment which is not less than 5 years, but which may extend to 7 years and also fine. Again, 5 to 7 is always depending upon the gravity of the acid, even the attempt of the एसिड अटैक, कितने पास से किया था, कितने दूर से किया था, कितना ज्यादा उसके साथ प्रॉब्लम हो सकती थी, तो दैट इज ऑल्सो डिफाइंड अंडर सेक्शन 326B ऑफ द आईपीसी. सेकेंडली, इफ द अटेम्प्ट हैज बीन ऑलरेडी मेड, दैट मीन्स इफ देयर इज एन एसिड अटैक, देन द पनिशमेंट इज मेंशन्ड अंडर 326A ऑफ आईपीसी, विच इज 10 ईयर्स एंड विच मे एक्सटेंड टू लाइफ इम्प्रिजनमेंट. So this is important, and that is good that even no matter after 2013, but this particular is considered now as an offense. Now the next thing is, which I think is very, very important, although this is not an amendment after 2013, but as I said that there are some other things which I really want you people to know, that there are certain provisions for you, that there is a right of virtual complaint. Now, virtual complaint means it is, I think everybody knows, ki agar kisi ko koi problem hoti hai, then they have to go to the particular police station to lodge a complaint. But now there is also a provision for the virtual complaints that if any lady or if anyone, this is not only for the women, for everyone, that if any person cannot come to the police station, maybe she is a child, maybe she is not supposed to go out of the home, maybe she is wrongfully detained or restrained, anything has been done, maybe she is not having a courage to go to the police station, and she want to lodge a complaint against anything bad which is happening with her, then she can lodge a virtual complaint to the police station through SMS, through WhatsApp, to the senior police officer of the level of deputy commissioner or commissioner of police. Now, once the virtual complaint is lodged to the senior member, then they direct the SHO of that particular police station. I think everybody knows that there is a jurisdiction of a particular area and a particular police station. Every area is having a separate police station, and every crime which is committed in that particular area, all the complaints related to that particular area will be lodged in the particular police station only. So once the complaint is virtually lodged, then the deputy commissioner or the commissioner of police will transfer that complaint to the SHO of that particular area. And then it will be verified by that person and the action will take place. So you are having this provision also to lodge a virtual complaint, which is important for everybody to know this. Then the second thing is, again, this is very important, that there is also a provision of zero FIR. Now, as I said, that there is a provision for FIR, ki agar aapko ek saath koi problem hoti hai, then it is the complaint or FIR must be lodged at the proper police station of that area only. But it may happen that you cannot come, that the crime has been committed in your area only. अब जैसे कि मैं आपको बताऊं, अगर मान लीजिए यू आर ट्रैवलिंग एंड चोरी हो जाती है आपके घर पे, बट यू आर नॉट एट दैट पर्टिकुलर होम, एट योर होम, देन यू कैन लॉन्च अ जीरो एफआईआर टू द अनदर सिटी आल्सो, टू द अनदर प्लेस आल्सो, टू द अनदर पुलिस स्टेशन आल्सो, एंड इफ इट इज नेसेसरी, इफ द ऑफेंस इज सीरियस इन नेचर, देन द एफआईआर विल बी लॉन्च टू एनी अदर पुलिस स्टेशन, बट यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दैट दैट पर्टिकुलर offense must be of serious nature and you are not in that particular वाकई में you are आप जा नहीं सकते हैं उस अपनी एरिया में, you are not either having a time or you are in a different city or anywhere else when you cannot go, और आपको लगता है कि ये चीज जल्दी हो जानी चाहिए, ये तुरंत लॉज होना चाहिए, पुलिस मस्ट टेक एक्शन ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर थिंग, देन ओनली यू कैन लॉज अ जीरो एफआईआर. डोंट गो फॉर द पिटी कॉसेस टू फाइल अ जीरो एफआईआर व्हेन यू कैन इजीली गो टू द पुलिस स्टेशन ऑफ योर पर्टिकुलर एरिया. तो इन दैट कंडीशन जीरो एफआईआर कुड बी लॉज टू एनी पुलिस स्टेशन एंड दैट विल बी ट्रांसफर टू द कंसर्न पुलिस स्टेशन. नाउ व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड एज जीरो एफआईआर? Because every FIR is having a number and that number is followed in the that particular area only, and you are filing an FIR to any other police station, that's why they write a number zero and they transfer that it to the concerned police station. तो इसीलिए उस जगह को हम जीरो एफआईआर कहते हैं, और जैसे ही वो दूसरी जगह एक कंसर्न जो जो ज्यूरिसडिक्शन में पुलिस स्टेशन वो ट्रांसफर हो जाती है तो हम उसको नंबर दे देते हैं, तो देन इट विल बी अ नंबर्ड एफआईआर. तो ये चीज होता है, दैट प्रोविजन इज आल्सो फॉर एनीबॉडी टू फाइल अ जीरो एफआईआर. दिस इज आल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर एवरीबॉडी टू नो. देन अगेन अ प्रोविजन फॉर वुमेन, दैट राइट नॉट टू बी अरेस्टेड एट नाइट, and also some of the provision related to arrest of women that I'm going to tell you. Pehli cheez jo aapko janna zyada zaruri hai, that any arrest of any women cannot be made after sunset and before sunrise except in the exceptional case that too after the order or the permission of the first class magistrate. Otherwise, there cannot be any arrest of a woman after sunset and before sunrise. Secondly, if any person or any policeman is coming to your home or anywhere else to arrest you, then it is necessary that there must be some female constable or a female police officer to make an arrest. Otherwise, they cannot arrest you. Similarly, even if there is a search warrant, if they have to make a search, physical also and search of your home also, then also it is necessary that there must be some female constable or a female police officer along with that person to make a search. Similarly, even at the time of interrogation of a woman, if there is an interrogation, then also if needed, a presence of the family member could be there, or there must be a female constable or a female police officer at the time of interrogation also. Similarly, you cannot detain any female at night in the police station without legal permission. If there is a legal permission, then you can detain, but otherwise you cannot detain, any police officer cannot detain any female in night at the police station without a legal permission. So these are the things. And if by any reason, if the police officer has to make it, then as I said, they have to take the permission by the first class magistrate. Then the next thing is related to basically laws pertaining to dowry death. Now there are many things. Dowry death is something which has been defined under four places. The first thing is Section 2 of Dowry Prohibition Act 1961, where it is only the definition of dowry. The definition of dowry, the demand of dowry, how it has been done, that has been defined. Now, as far as criminal justice system, that is IPC, is concerned, Section 304B of Indian Penal Code defined dowry death, not dowry, but dowry death. Then Section 498A is something which defines cruelty or domestic violence because of, due to dowry. Then Section 113B of the Indian Evidence Act is something, as I said, evidence is always necessary to frame any offense. So that has been defined under Section 113B of Indian Evidence Act. So I'm not going to tell you in detail all the sections, but because that will take much time, so I'm going to tell you only Section 304B and 498A of IPC, which is related to dowry death only, and the cruelty and the domestic violence related to dowry. So Section 304B, what happened in 80s, if we talk about 80s, there was a rampant cases of dowry death in India. Bahut sare cases hote the, especially in UP and in Haryana. Bahut jyada cases the of dowry death. At that particular time, the Dowry Prevention Act was also made, and the amendment in IPC was also done in the way of Section 304B. Ye kyun hua tha? If there is any, I think everybody knows what is dowry and how it is taken, so I'm not going to tell you all these things. The only thing which I'm going to tell you, which is related to the death of the person. If there is any death of any lady within the 7 years of her marriage, that too, if it is proved that it is because of the demand of dowry or the cruelty or harassment of husband or the relative of husband for dowry, that will be amount as dowry death. So the major thing which is necessary, or the ingredients which is necessary for you to know it, the first thing, the death must be within 7 years of marriage. Second, the death must be because of the demand of dowry. Secondly, by the harassment or cruelty by husband and the relatives of the husband, then it will be amount as dowry death. For which, and if there is a death, it is also necessary to prove, yahan ye cheez important hai, which has been mentioned under Section 113B of Evidence Act. Kyunki hum evidence ki baat karte, to it is necessary that if there is a death, it is necessary to prove that there is harassment or cruelty has been done to against that particular bride or a lady. वो चीज प्रूव होना जरूरी है, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट ओनली शी हैज कमिटेड दैट थिंग. क्योंकि उसमें नॉट ओनली अ डाउरी डेथ कुड बी बाय बर्न आल्सो बाय सुसाइड आल्सो, इवन द अटेम्प्ट ऑफ सुसाइड हैज बीन डन, या सुसाइड हो चुका है, तो दैट इज ऑल्सो कंसिडर्ड एज अ डाउरी डेथ. पर वो चीज दैट इज वेरी टेक्निकल, and that's why that particular act of evidence, section of evidence is necessary to be proved at the time of trial. कि वो चीज होना, that purpose has to be clearly mentioned, and if that is proved, then the punishment for that is not less than 7 years, which may extend to imprisonment for life. So this is related to dowry death. And the second thing is Section 498A of the Indian Penal Code. Again, this is related to the harassment and cruelty which is done by the husband and the husband's relatives to any women, but that particular harassment and cruelty must be related to dowry only. make it very clear, there is always a confusion. Every domestic violence cannot be treated as the demand of dowry. 498A is for the protection of the women. वो है कि एक वायलेंस नहीं होना चाहिए, क्रुएलिटी नहीं होनी चाहिए, बट द फैक्टर विच इज नेसेसरी टू एड इज देयर मस्ट बी डिमांड ऑफ डाउरी इन एनी सेंसेस. सो यू हैव टू रिलेटेड, दैट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर एवरीबडी टू नो दैट दैट हैरेसमेंट एंड क्रुएलिटी इज रिलेटेड टू डाउरी डिमांड ओनली. अगर इस तरीके से कोई चीज होती है देन द हस्बैंड देयर, अर्लियर जो था वो था कि देन द कंप्लेंट, देन द अरेस्ट कैन बी मेड विदाउट एनी, ओनली ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द कंप्लेंट. कोई वारंट की जरूरत नहीं होती थी, सिर्फ कंप्लेंट के बेस पे अरेस्ट हो जाता था. बट ग्रेजुअली उसका बहुत ज्यादा मिसयूज होने लगा था सेक्शन 498A का. तो अब उसमें अमेंडमेंट आ गया और चेंज हो गया है कि इट विल नॉट बी ओनली ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द कंप्लेंट ऑफ द वुमेन, देयर विल बी सम इंक्वायरी ऑल्सो एंड देन देयर विल द अरेस्ट विल बी मेड. तो ये एक चेंज हुआ था अगेन. ऑल्दो दिस पर्टिकुलर सेक्शन हैज बीन मेड फॉर द क्रुएलिटी एंड हैरेसमेंट of the made by husband and their relatives. Yeah, this is important. And lastly, the last thing which I want to tell to you, that there is a National Commission for Women Act, for Women Act 1990. Under this, there is a setup of a statutory body in January 1992. Which is basically to review the constitutional and legal, the legally safeguard for women, the legal safeguard for women, and recommend remedial legislative measures, facilitate redressal of grievance, and advise the government on all policy matters affecting women. So this is also very important, and there is a separate National Commission for Women who which is working for all the women in India. So this is all about the significant provisions for women. And for that, I want to say about me also that as I said earlier also that I am having my YouTube channel by the name of Dr. Priya Sipa, and we are also having our website, that is lawcolloquy.com. Apart from this, we are having a page on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, LinkedIn, everywhere by the name of Law Colloquy, where we are sharing n numbers of videos also, laws also, everything pertaining to this law. So that's all for today. I think everybody knows and understand. So if you have any question, you can ask me.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Thank you, Dr. Priya. And I want to convey my heartfelt thanks to you for taking out time and to be with us and sharing your valuable knowledge and legal expertise on such a matter. And you have explained everything in such a simple way, in an understandable way. And I'm really grateful for, you know, telling us about the virtual complaint and the right to zero FIR kind of provisions. And I'm quite sure that most of us were not aware of these provisions, although living in a very, in a very well-placed city. And I think these provisions are so empowering for a victim and her family, as there is always a lot of hesitation on the part of victim and her family to, you know, go to a police station and just lodge FIRs. So I'm really grateful and thankful to you. So now, audience, I'm opening the session for your queries and for your interaction. If you have any queries or observations, or if you want to share something, so please feel free to, to come up with your questions. And we are taking up. Yes, girls. Yes, audience. If you have any questions and queries, either you can write it in the chat box or you can ask it directly by unmuting yourself.
Ma'am, can I start, please?
Yeah, sure, Taruna. You can come.
Good afternoon, ma'am. First of all, it was a really interactive session because such sessions are really important, especially for the girls. So, ma'am, I just wanted to ask you something. Like, I have been, like, I have talked to many girls, and to be very honest, I won't name the girls, but yes, there are so many girls who have been actually, you know, victimized in their childhood for like molestation by their own people, relatives only. And you know what? They are so small that they don't even know that what they are going through is actually wrong. So when they realize, when they are growing up in their adolescence, they actually realize ki jo bhi bachpan mein hua tha, that was really wrong. And this thing, you know what, this thing actually just makes my heart heavy, because I have my own sister who had actually gone through this, and she just told me like couple of days back what she had been faced. So I just want to know, how can we just minimize this thing, or you know, completely eradicate this thing from the society, that small girls are being victimized, and this is something we really need to take care of.
The thing is, as I said earlier also in the starting of my webinar, that it is only awareness. Never think that this is a very tender age that you cannot speak about these type of crime, because you have to make aware everybody what is good touch, what is bad touch. At the very, very early age, the moment a child started walking and understanding about that touch, you have to teach every girl that what is the difference between good touch and bad touch earlier. The moment you are going to tell us, and it starts from the family only, any person. And if the family, you have to make other people also aware, within family also, outside family also, make aware and spread awareness as much as you can. That is the only way to prevent, because prevention is better than crime, as always says. And as I always said, that you have to be very vigilant. Aapko pure taraf, charo taraf dekhna hai all the time. And you cannot, because there are n number of incest cases. Incest cases, agar aap National Crime Bureau dekho, to incest cases are flooded. So you have to take care. So always teach everyone the difference between good touch and bad touch. Okay, I hope you understand.
Thank you a lot, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Now there is another question in the chat box. Yes, Amrit, would you like to ask your question by unmuting yourself, or should I read your question? I think I'll read it. Amrit Kaur, she's asking that that it is ground reality that women residing in backward areas and villages are not aware of the rights related to violence. Even if they have a little knowledge and were abused, they never sought help from anyone due to the concept of izzat. So how to aware these women, and how to change their tradition? This is the question she is putting.
Again, as you only said, that it is necessary to make the awareness. And believe me, that there are n number of workshops has been taken by me in very interior of MP. MP ke bahut sare interior villages mein jaake maine khud bahut sare sessions liye hain with I have a collaboration with not only the police department but also by women and child development authority, the department of women and child development. I am also frequently called a resource person for these type of awareness. So I have made all of them aware about these things, and not only me, women and child development of the department jo hai, they are making a very much efforts. But the thing is, you have to be again, आपको भी जाना पड़ेगा जब इस तरीके से कोई workshops होती है, जब इस तरीके से कोई seminar होती है, it is necessary for you people also to go. इसीलिए मैं कहती हूँ कि the word publicity is the most effective one. आप जितना ज्यादा बोलोगे, जितना ज्यादा समझाओगे दूसरों को, तो उतना ही ज्यादा अच्छा होगा. और एंड द सेकंड थिंग इज, लोग ऐसा कहते हैं दैट इन इंटीरियर दे आर नॉट हैविंग एनी सोशल मीडिया व्हाट टू से रीच, बट दे आर हैविंग मोबाइल. Now mobile is something जिसमें आप बहुत अच्छे से बोल सकते हैं. If they can watch movie, if they can watch see songs and anything else, and if they can forward messages, आप सबके पास आजकल देते. Why don't you tell them that there are workshops also for them? They can go there or send them messages related to this, that they are having a right. So these are the things. These are the small things which you can do for those persons who are. But other than this, I really know that women, child and women department are really doing a great job, and they are really working for it. But we are having a big population, so usko thoda sa it will take time to make them aware. That is any other question?
Oh yes, ma'am, I have one more question.
Yes, Anna.
Hello, go ahead.
Yes, ma'am. I was saying that somewhere we really need to educate, I guess, parents also who are not able to impart this kind of knowledge, which actually we get this knowledge in our college days or in the high school. But this is something we need, like our parents need to impart such knowledge. So how can parents be like, how can they, parents can actually help girls with such knowledge or boys also? Because even boys are victimized.
That is the answer is same that you have to give them aware. Yehi cheez hai beta. Har jagah yehi cheez kehna hai. The more, either by the word publicity or by any such camps, any webinar, any seminars of that particular place, or even you can send some WhatsApp messages, a short movies. There are n number of movies related to this good touch and bad touch also, for awareness of the child also. You can make them aware. And if the parents aren't aware, it's just your responsibility to make them aware. No issue. Or you can ask their friends to make them aware if you are comfortable with them. Kisi bhi tarike se, koi bhi, ye koi zaruri nahi hai ki bache nahi kar sakte. Bache bahut achhe teacher ho sakte hain. But wo depend karta hai. Aap kaise bhi, kisi bhi tarike se un tak baat pahunchaiye. And tell them to join such sessions.
Thank you, ma'am.
And definitely, yes. And definitely in our POCSO Act, this is otherwise, agar hum iski baat karte about the criminal justice system purely of IPC and CRPC, that is more for this women. Aurton ke liye wo jyada bana hai, but POCSO Act is something which is related to that is gender neutral, and that is for both male and female both. So we are having laws related to that only. Wo bhi hai. Yes, anyone else?
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon.
Ma'am, I want to ask, like, jab aise kuch incident hota hai, when girl is sexually assaulted, तो इवन आफ्टर क्रिमिनल प्रोसीडिंग तो वो मेंटली बहुत इंपैक्ट कर जाती है.
मेंटली बहुत क्या हो जाती है?
इंपैक्ट कर जाती है वो चीज. लाइक आई हैव अ फ्रेंड, मतलब शी वाज असॉल्टेड व्हेन शी वाज 14 एंड नाउ शी इज 25 एंड नाउ स्टिल कहीं ना कहीं उस चीज को वो कोप अप नहीं कर पा रही है. तो वो चीज उसके माइंड पे वो करती रहती है एंड शी स्टिल गेट्स नाइटमेयर्स. एंड अभी भी उसकी फैमिली देयर लाइक कि उसको कहीं ना कहीं पॉइंट आउट करते हैं कि हाँ शायद इसको उस टाइम पे इट वाज अ ट्रिप, नहीं भेजना चाहिए था, वो नहीं करना चाहिए था. तो मैम आई बिलीव इट इज इनबिल्ट इन आवर सोशलाइजेशन. वी टीच आवर गर्ल्स टू ऐसे टू स्टे साइलेंट और ऐसे नहीं. उस चीज की वजह से भी काफी मेंटल हेल्थ हैम्पर्ड रहती है.
इसीलिए मैंने आपको शुरू में बोला कि जब तक वो सिर्फ वर्ड्स की बात होती है तब तक तो हम फर्स्ट टाइम इग्नोर कर सकते हैं. सेकेंड टाइम यू शुड नॉट इग्नोर दैट टू. इट इज ओनली रिलेटेड टू वर्ड्स. हम सिर्फ वर्ड्स की बात करते हैं, जेस्चर पोस्चर की भी बात करते हैं, मगर जहां वो चीज ज्यादा होती है तो वो हमको अपनी वॉइस रेज करनी चाहिए. सबसे पहले किसी भी तरीके का टच होता है, चाहे वो इवन अगर फादर ने भी किया आपको गलत तरीके से टच, तो आप मम्मा को बताइए. ये बात बहुत क्लियरली बतानी चाहिए बच्चों को कि क्या चीज ऐसी होती है और कौन सी चीजें आपके बॉडी पार्ट्स होते हैं विच शुड नॉट बी विजिबल टू एनीबॉडी एल्स आल्सो. ठीक है, नो मैटर ही इज योर फादर, वो भी चीज होती है. तो वो चीज पहले बहुत ज्यादा जरूरी होती है कि बचपन में उनको ये चीज समझाई जाए. पहली चीज वो. दूसरी चीज ये कि अगर कोई चीज ये हो जाती है तो एज आई सेड दैट देयर इज अ पॉक्सो एक्ट. इफ द गर्ल इज ट्रॉमेटराइज, पहले जरूर ये होता था कि अब क्या होता है ना कि लोग घर में ही दबा देते हैं उस बात को, आगे ले जाने की बात नहीं करते. जबकि अब जो पॉक्सो एक्ट में जो प्रोविजन हो गया है उसमें ये चीज होती है कि अगर आपके साथ गलत होता है देन इट इज मैंडेटरी एंड इट इज लॉ अंडर पॉक्सो एक्ट दैट इट शुड नॉट बी डिस्क्लोज. किसी भी फीमेल का या मेल का, बच्चा है, लड़का या लड़की है, हुएवर इज अ विक्टिम, हिज नेम, हिज आइडेंटिटी शुड नॉट बी डिस्क्लोज. No matter it is on media or anywhere else. First thing. Second thing, which is very important to know, that if there is any sexual assault which has been done to any male or female, and if that particular person doesn't want to come to the trial and doesn't want to face that particular person who has done something wrong with him or her, then it is also understood by the court, or it is not at all necessary for that victim to even appear directly, क्योंकि वो बच्चा बहुत traumatized है और वो नहीं आ सकता है सामने और वो नहीं देखना चाहता है उस आदमी को या औरत को जिसने उसके साथ गलत किया है, तो भी वो माना गया है और जरूरी नहीं होता है कि वो सामने आए, उसके बिना सामने आए भी ट्रायल होता है। अगर बच्चा कोर्ट में भी नहीं आना चाहता है पॉक्सो एक्ट के अंदर, तो वो घर से ही स्काइप के थ्रू या अदर मोड ऑफ जैसे ये गूगल मीट है, ये सारी चीजें इसके थ्रू भी ट्रायल हो जाता है। ये सारे प्रोविजन अब एड कर दिए गए हैं। और अगर ये चीज होती है, जैसे आप अपनी फ्रेंड की बात कर रही हैं, तो एक काउंसलिंग सेशन जरूर करना चाहिए साइकेट्रिस्ट के साथ। ऑलवेज रिमेम्बर दैट काउंसलिंग सेशन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। हमेशा साइकेट्रिस्ट के पास जाना को कोई मेंटल इलनेस नहीं कहा जाते। बहुत सारे फैक्टर्स होते हैं जहां पे अगर हम बोल देते हैं और वो अगर चीजें बताते हैं तो इट कैन बी रिजॉल्व्ड। तो काउंसलिंग सेशन मस्ट बी एनकरेज्ड, नॉट डिस्करेज्ड, और लेबल इट एज अ मेंटल इलनेस। इट इज नॉट अ मेंटल इलनेस। वो मेंटल इलनेस नहीं है, उसको बोलना चाहिए। तो यू मस्ट एनकरेज हर ऑल्सो एंड टू एनी वन एल्स ऑल्सो that one can go for the counseling session. These are the things.
Thank you, Dr. Priya. Now we have another question in the chat box. Yes, Akshita, can you want to ask your question? Roll number 5659, or should I read your question? Okay, I'll just read out. She's saying that, ma'am, you said about the right to registration a virtual complaint. Ma'am, what is the procedure for it and where it is to be registered? Like, is there any specific portal or website which is available?
देखिए, आपको आपकी जगह का, the area where you are residing, you can easily get the number of the Deputy Commissioner of Police or IG of Police, even the Commissioner of Police on net of that particular city. You can lodge the complaint through email. You will get on portal the phone number also and email address also of that police officer who is of senior level easily. So you can lodge complaint through email, virtual complaint to that particular officer by telling all the things. And he is going to transfer that complaint to the SHO of your locality. So that can be, there is no portal. There is only a phone number and email address. So you can email it.
So I think you can check the website, local website,
yes,
of
local website, yes,
department in the city, and then I think you can use that portal. Thank you, Dr. Priya. There is another question by another student, Akshita, and she's saying, ma'am, in the case of dowry death, why is it that the time limit is only for 7 years? And then what are the provisions to fight cases of flashing and inappropriate pictures that are sent online? And another question is there from her side. What are your thoughts about teaching and introducing these rights in schools itself? We are taught about the water cycle or geometry since a very young age, but haven't really found any application in my life as now. So she's talking about teaching these soft skills and making aware of the students regarding the legal provisions, which are quite helpful in our life.
So the first question about the time limit of 7 years of dowry death, because it is considered that till 7 years, a girl is not able to speak up. And from that time only, it was, kyunki jitne bhi cases hue the, in 80s, as I said, after in 80s, there was a rapid increase of dowry death in UP and Haryana, and I'm sorry to say in Punjab also. So there was a rapid increase of death, and it is observed that most of the cases were within 7 years of marriage only, most of the cases. That's why this particular time limit has been taken care of, or ye bana di gayi hai. But if it is needed, then also the charge of dowry death can be that. Afterwards, it cannot be dowry death, but it could be domestic violence under section 498A. Kyunki 498A mein there is no time limit. It is not mentioned. It is only of death in 304B, and in 498A, it is related to cruelty and harassment by husband and husband's relative. So there is a difference. So it is needed, and it is your responsibility also, and it is the girl's responsibility also to raise voice against their in-laws if she is having any problems. 7 years is a pretty long time to raise voice, and she can raise her voice, and even the parents of that particular girl can raise voice. And if you are still not vigilant, if you are still tolerating all these things, that is not good. Then you cannot blame law. You have to be vigilant. You have to be aware. That's why this particular thing has been done. Now, I did not remember your second question, but third question, which is related to the why don't we spread such type of awareness in the school? It may happen that in your school, it is not such type of seminars were not there. But as I said, I personally have taken many seminars, many workshops in school, right from class 5 to class 12, and make them aware about the good touch, bad touch, and all the criminal law and all the provisions pertaining to women. And I make all boys also to present in that particular seminar, because they must understand that if you are going to do such type of things, this type of punishment will be given to you. So it is necessary for boys also to attend these type of seminars. So I went to n number of schools to do. And now there are many seminars in the schools also related to this.
Yes, ma'am.
And what was the second question? Can you please
repeat, ma'am? Just read out the second question. Yes. It was, yes. What are the provisions to fight cases of flashing or flashing inappropriate pictures that are sent online? So she's talking about online content, which is inappropriate.
Yes. Yes, that is outrage to modesty of women. So you can lodge a complaint. One thing more, 66E of the Cyber Act also, jo humne uski baat hum karte hain, that is also related with purely online data, purely online, not offline. Offline bhi kai cheeze hoti hai na, ki agar aap ja rahe ho aur aapko samne se bhi chhed raha hai wo aadmi, aapke saath us tarah kar raha hai aur saath mein pictures bhi de raha hai. So then you get confused where to lodge complaints, whether it is under cyber law or it is under IPC. So it's better to go for IPC if it is personal, offline also. But if it is only online, then you can again go to the police station, and there is a provision under Section 66E of the Information Technology Act also, where the punishment has been mentioned for such type of things. So aap hamesha bilkul jaiye, if there is a stalking, if there is voyeurism, or if there is any outrage of modesty at that particular thing. But if you are working, agar aap bade ho gaye, if you are working, that comes under sexual harassment at workplace, then you can go to the internal complaint committee. And you can do. And always remember, if anything is happening in your college, with you, by any member of the school, no matter it is your peon, your bus driver, Mali, anyone who is working, then you can go to your principal, you go to the internal complaint committee to lodge the complaint against that person. That will be taken care.
Thank you, Dr. Priya. Yes. Now there is another person who wants to ask a question. She is Jasmine Sidhu. Yes, Jasmine, you can unmute yourself if you want to ask the question.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, like whatever acts have been made, that was actually required for our country and as well as in every country, like whether it was for sexual harassment or domestic violence. But in today's society, there are some women or girls who are using these acts for their own benefit, yes. Like whether it is for money or it's for property. So I'm familiar with a case in which a girl has charged a rape case on the boy, and after filing a case, after 2-3 months, she's ringing up the guy and she's asking ki mujhe 30 lakh do, I'll take my case back. So what can be done in such cases?
As I said earlier also, when I was speaking about 498A, that because of the misuse of that act, the amendment, there is an amendment again, that now there is no direct arrest of any husband or husband's relative because of the misuse of 498A. Similarly, if there is any charge of rape or molestation or sexual harassment, then also, and if it is proved that the false allegation has been done or false complaint has been made, then there are strict action against that lady. And there is a provision in IPC, and that lady is given is punished for that particular offense. For that, there are many cases. Bahut sare aise cases hain jab false allegation mein, if it is proved that it is false, then the charges against of defamation also, and for other things against that lady.
Yes, Dr. Priya, I think even regarding dowry cases, I have seen that yes. there are many false complaints, and even the boy's family is suffering a lot without any reason. So is there any provision for such cases where the case is not valid?
Yes, there are many cases. There are many cases. And because of that only, that comes not only under defamation, but also again the harassment made by the girl, or by the lady. And there are n number of charges, depend upon which type and up to which extent the harassment has been done by the lady to the in-laws or any other person. तो उस पे डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द ग्रेविटी ऑफ द क्राइम एंड द टाइप ऑफ ऑफेंस शी हैज कमिटेड देयर आर सेक्शन एन नंबर ऑफ सेक्शन व्हिच इज इन फेवर ऑफ मेन एंड द पनिशमेंट हैज बीन गिवन टू दैट पर्टिकुलर लेडी अदरवाइज डिफेमेशन इज ऑलवेज देयर डिफेमेशन में तो ये चीजें होती ही है कि आपने उनका नाम बदनाम किया है तो वो चीजें देयर आर एन नंबर ऑफ सेक्शंस और देयर आर एन नंबर ऑफ केसेस ऑफ 498A मैंने तो एक पेपर भी जो प्रेजेंट किया है एंड व्हिच इज वेरी पॉपुलर इज द मिसयूज ऑफ 498A ओनली तो आपको वो आराम से एकेडमीया वगैरह में पढ़ने को मिल जाएगा तो देयर आर एन नंबर ऑफ केसेस देयर आर एन नंबर ऑफ केसेस व्हिच आई हैव मेंशनड इन दैट particular okay. paper.
Thank you very much, ma'am, and it sounds very interesting study, and it will be nice if you share the link of that paper, so I think it will be of a great use to our audience and to our students. And there is, ma'am, another question by Monica, and she's saying that ma'am, do you think that this should be made included this should be included as compulsory subject in schools and colleges? So I think yes. she wants to work in this area, and she wants that it should be taught in the schools at the school and college level.
If it should not be taught, but there must be a regular seminars or workshops. If it is not made compulsory as a subject, but still it is necessary that there must be regular seminars, because otherwise, if their legal studies are there in your colleges or in your school, then you are having these cases. Then you are going to read everything related to it, but it is not necessary. Most of the science student doesn't read this. So SMA, it is necessary that there must be some workshop, regular workshop or seminars related to this in your schools.
Yes, ma'am, I just want to share this, that our college is taking this initiative, and from time to time we are organizing such webinars, seminars and conferences where we try to spread awareness regarding these provisions. And in the college also we have a very active internal complaint committee where we are handling such cases, and we have external members as well as internal members in it. So they are really playing very active role in sorting such problems. So ma'am, there is another question from Mansi, and she's saying we have many good provisions to safeguard women, but the bitter reality is that people who are powerful or rich, they can easily suppress the case or bribe the police officials, and they can easily get away with the complaints and roam freely. It is happening in our country. What is your say on it? So yes, this is also another flip side of these legal provisions, that sometimes the elite class is misusing them. So ma'am, she wants to know your take on it.
There is a very popular saying that laws are made to be broken. So, वो तो है कि whenever there is a law, there are lot many loopholes also. So, but I must say that it is not always right. There are many cases in which many popular term हम कहें तो big shots are involved, and many competent person, a person from a very basically dignitaries are involved, and we are reading their cases. Why we are reading? Because the action has been already taken. We can talk about Priyadarshini Mattu case, where everybody knows about Priyadarshini Mattu case. That is a case of a murder and rape done by the son of IG Police Delhi, इतना पॉपुलर केस था, जेसिका लाल केस आपको पता होगा. जेसिका लाल केस में भी द पर्सन वॉज इन्वॉल्व वॉज फ्रॉम अ वेरी हाई हाई सोसाइटी. सो यस, इट टेक्स टाइम एंड इट अदर देन दिस डेफिनेटली देर इज मच efforts has to be made in such type of cases, but the only thing is now we are having social media with us. Press media is very vigilant and they always, aajkal to sahi bhi baat agar police wale karte rehte hai na to bhi recording karke log dal dete hai social media pe. So if any person is doing bad, so you are having in your hand only social media. You can spread any video, anything through media, but that has to be very genuine. Always remember that is that should not be defamation. Wo bahut genuine cheez honi chahiye. So you are having n number of provisions now, n number of things within you and with you, so that you can spare lot many more awareness, and the action could be taken by the judiciary also, by the legislative also. तो ये चीजें तो हो सकती हैं. तो जो मैंने कहा लूप होल होने के बावजूद यू आर हैविंग दैट टाइप ऑफ प्रोविजंस एंड मीडिया इज रियली विजिलेंट एंड देयर आर एन नंबर ऑफ केसेस बिकॉज ऑफ मीडिया दैट हैज बीन सॉल्व्ड. नो मैटर इट इज एज आई सेड दैट जेसिका लाल एंड प्रियदर्शनी मट्टू केसेस आर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट केस विच आर सॉल्व्ड जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ मीडिया ऑल्सो. इवन निर्भया केस, निर्भया केस, बहुत सारे गैंग रेप केस होते हैं. अभी एक जगह और हुआ था एमपी में ही, सॉरी यूपी में हुआ था, लेकिन उसका इतना नहीं हाईलाइट हुआ था. बथुआ केस हुआ था अभी, उसे मेरा एक उसमें था भी, लेकिन वो उसमें, लेकिन उसको नहीं इतना ज्यादा हाईलाइट हुआ. क्यों? क्योंकि उसमें मीडिया ने ज्यादा इंटरेस्ट नहीं लिया. मगर निर्भया केस आप सबको पता है 2013 का अमेंडमेंट बेस इज जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ निर्भया केस. सो These are the provisions. इस तरीके से आप कम से कम पहुंचा सकते हैं अपनी बातें. I think that is the thing. And the more you can speak up.
Yes, yes, very true, ma'am. And I think we are blessed that we are living in a democratic setup, and we have a strong judiciary and very effective media also, which is coming up with such cases. You know, just recently when I was, exploring that why we celebrate this Denim Day, then I came across that this day is celebrated because in Italy, in one of the, trial rape cases, the survivor was blamed for her rape because she was wearing very tight jeans.
Yes.
And, Supreme Court ordered in, against the victim, and she was declared as a culprit. So thankfully, we are not living in such country where the judiciary is not having that kind of stereotypical mindset. Our judiciary is very open, and they are always coming up with very, very effective judgments to control this sexual harassment in the society. So I think the only thing which is required is to spread awareness regarding these rights. I think that is the main lacuna which we have to work on. And I think all our audience, all our students, they can work as torchbearers in this area. So after gaining awareness, they can spread it, but please make sure that you are spreading authentic, reliable information, as Naeem said. Yeah. Thank you very much, ma'am, for taking up queries and giving them such, reliable kind of content. Now I invite Dr. Gurjeet for formal vote of thanks. Yes, Dr. Gurjeet, are you there? Yeah.
Yes, am I audible to all? Yes, very good afternoon to everyone present here. I am here to present vote of thanks for today's webinar entitled Significant Provisions for Women in Indian Criminal Justice System. First of all, I would like to thank our resource person, Professor Priya Ma'am, for enlightening us with their knowledge on criminal justice system in India, with special reference to women regarding their issues and concerns. Today's webinar was full of knowledge and interesting things. It gave in deep insights into the topic and also revealed some interesting facts. Ma'am highlighted various issues with regard to criminal justice. Ma'am highlighted the meaning of offense, all the amendment or recent amendments, especially for women in Indian criminal system. Firstly, the very first thing she pointed out is that we should be aware about the amendments. We should not misuse the amendments or acts. Secondly, she clearly defined different offenses with reference to criminal justice system like stalking, voyeurism, insert the modesty of women, sexual harassment at workplace, then National Commission Act, Domestic Violence Act, laws pertaining to dowry debts, right to virtual complaint, right to zero FIR, etc. Not only this, ma'am provided us valuable guidance how to proceed or follow the proceeding for using these acts. It was really informative, ma'am, for all of us, as it is a need of an hour for in the modern society. Once again, I would like to thank Professor Priya ma'am for taking out time for the busy schedule and enlightening us with the knowledge with regard to this criminal system, judicial system in India. And not only this, I would like to have your presence, ma'am, in future also such type of lectures. I would like to thank our college principal, ma'am, for giving us permission and support to organizing this webinar. Not only this, I would like to thank Dr. Bhavna Sood, ma'am, head of the Department of Sociology, for organizing this seminar on this current issue. Last but not the least, I want to thank our faculty members and dear student whose presence really makes this event successful. Thank you to all.
Thank you very much, Dr. Gurjeet, for making a formal vote of thanks. And now I just want to request all the participants to please switch on their cameras for a virtual picture, because this will stay in our memory that we have attended this workshop and acquired a bit of knowledge about this issue. Yes, girls, can you please switch on your cameras? Yes, audience. Yes, girls, please do it quickly.
One thing again I want to mention, if you have missed anything, you can watch my YouTube channel, because I have made separate videos on voyeurism also, zero FIR, and sexual harassment in workplace, dowry death, and many other things. So if you want to see, watch it again, you can watch it.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much, ma'am, for telling us about the various. Thankful to the audience also for participating so actively in the workshop and asking the questions, and it has made the workshop more valuable. Okay, and it's a very strange thing that we have to end the webinars nowadays with just a click of button. Okay, otherwise we would have continued the discussion at the cup of tea. But fortunately and unfortunately, we are meeting at this platform, but we are looking forward to have you in person in our college, ma'am, in the near future. So thank you very much for sparing your valuable time. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you, ma'am. And thank you, Bhavna, ma'am, for calling me and having me. I really enjoyed a lot with a lovely audience. Thank you. Thank you.
Welcome, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Pleasure was ours. Awesome.